If you think about the numbers of South America, talking about South America, no, not Spain, the numbers are amazing. We need a bit more promotion. If we promote more and we connect better, definitely the numbers will increase.
For example, we got a lot of Argentinians that with the new Air New Zealand fly, that the direct fly from Buenos Aires to Auckland, this market grow a lot. Brazil is like a dormant giant. And I think if Air New Zealand enter in Brazil or they arrive in Brazil with the Air New Zealand plane, we can wake up the giant. Give the people that are coming from this big city or this big market time to realize that here the rhythm is different. And because sometimes they're coming stressed or accelerated, but after 2 or 3 days, they realize that, oh, it's not much stress, or it's more quiet, or everything, or nobody, for example, like a safety, sometimes the women are with the handbag all the time. I said, it's not a problem, you can leave it, nobody's going to take it. And when they realize, our way to ask for the thing can sounds a little rude, maybe we are not so polite, but it's like it's a cultural thing. It's like for example, here it's very installed like a please and thank you, and we don't use much the please, and it's like we ask, I want this, and it can in English can sounds very rude.
We are not that formal, no, in regards of time, and we are last minute booking, and for us it's the norm, no, we just plan our holidays 2 months in advance, and you are booking quite a lot of time in advance. So if you are from this side, say, oh, this is crazy, they're trying to book New Year holidays in 2 months in advance. But no, for them, they are quite advanced. No, so this kind of understanding, and don't get angry or hammering them just because they are booking late, it helps. No, it's how things work there. And you have to understand in a context where they operate, no, where the economy change, the exchange rate change all the time, and sometimes they don't want you booking earlier. People love the Kiwi culture. They just get fall in love, not only with the nature, just with the people. I think it's just be yourself, be open to this kind of different that we are not. Yeah, we might get a bit late, but that is how we are. But it's, no, don't take it personal.
In Spain or in South America, we are used to have dinner very late, 8:30, 9 p.m. as the earliest. And when the people come here and they have to have dinner at 5:30 or 6 p.m., it's a big change. And sometimes they are finding very difficult, because if they are going to a restaurant at 8:30, in little towns, maybe they cannot find any restaurant open. We used to eat with bread, and it's like sometimes if they, for example, who has restaurant and thing, and they want to give a better service, if they put like a plate with bread, they are going to love it. And we are not used to pay for the bread. And when they are being charged for bread, I said, how rude, you're charging me for a bread. But these kind of things are the cultural difference. But on the other hand, for example, sometimes we are surprised that the water is free, because we in our country, if you want water, you have to pay for the water, because they are not serving tap water in the tables. I think one important message, and if they want to engage with this market, could be have more material in Spanish, recorded commentaries, they are doing with the Chinese or the Japanese.
I think the language barrier is huge. I don't know, if we produce collateral and if we engage, it's a lot of people that speak Spanish living now in New Zealand. And if we engage more with those people and we use those resources, we leverage those resources, the impact could be huge. And if you get, again, information in Spanish, people that speak Spanish or Portuguese, you're going to be ahead from your competitors.
The people from Brazil or Portugal are used to to travel with the Spanish because it's very similar. But if we can have Spanish, it would be great. If we go the Portuguese, would be much better, and it's going to be a very good surprise for the Portuguese people.
I think there is a huge need to bridge the two cultures between, New Zealand and the Latin market. Better understanding of their needs, not put all the Latin market in the same bag, which is okay when you start. No, it's an emerging market, or and we talk about Latin America, no, and it's trying to think about Europe as a whole and don't differentiate the Germans with the Italian. No, that is a bit the same way in South America. The Mexican are a bit different from people from Argentina, and the Brazilians to the Chileans, etc. No, so there are differences. Let's say if you are in Franz Josef and you try to talk about our glaciers here in New Zealand to an Argentinian, and you don't know what is the glaciers look like in Argentina, probably the people can be a bit disappointed. No, so the more you get engaged and you know the market, I think it's the better. Huge potential with the Latin market in general. The more we push and more people get involved with the Latin market, it's better for everyone.